गुड मॉर्निंग डियर कैडेट्स। सो स्टडी आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड द न्यूक्लियोफिलिक एडिशन रिएक्शन फॉलोड बाय द लॉस ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स। स्पेशली दोज रिएक्शंस बिलोंग्स टू द अमोनिया एंड इट्स डिराइवेटिव्स रिएक्शंस। ओके, सो स्टडी वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड दैट वन। नाउ टुडे अनदर कैटेगरी ऑफ रिएक्शन इज देयर, दैट इज द रिडक्शन रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन। सो एक्चुअली रिडक्शन रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, आई हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड व्हेन आई टॉट यू मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अल्कोहल। ओके, बिकॉज व्हेन अल्डिहाइड इज रिड्यूस्ड 1 degree अल्कोहल इज फॉर्म, सो दैट इज द मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन फॉर द अल्कोहल एंड हियर इट इज द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन। ओके, सो जस्ट सी सम डिटेल आइडिया इज ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड बिकॉज नाउ सो मेनी रीजन्स असर्शन टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर इंक्लूडेड, MCQ इज इंक्लूडेड, सेक्शन ए इज कम्प्लीटली ऑब्जेक्टिव टाइप, सो वी शुड हैव सम थ्योरिटिकल नॉलेज ऑल्सो, देन ओनली वी कैन सॉल्व ऑल दोज क्वेश्चन। सो कीपिंग इन माइंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स, आई हैव कैटेगराइज्ड रिडक्शन रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन इन टू 2 categories, दैट इज द कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन एंड सेकंड वन इज द स्पेशल रिडक्शन। सो कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन मीन्स हाइड्रोजनेशन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ निकिल, PD एंड PT। ओके, सेकंड वन इज कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन इज रिडक्शन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सोडियम बोरोहाइड्राइड। थर्ड वन इज कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ लिथियम एल्युमिनियम हाइड्राइड। ओके, सो दीज थ्री आर कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन एंड ऑल केसेस प्रोडक्ट इज अल्कोहल ओनली। अल्डिहाइड रिडक्शन प्रोडक्ट इज 1 degree अल्कोहल, कीटोन रिडक्शन प्रोडक्ट इज 2 degree अल्कोहल। ओके, करेक्ट। अब नाउ जस्ट सी सेकंड वन इज स्पेशल रिडक्शन। स्पेशल रिडक्शन 2 name रिएक्शंस आर देयर, क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन एंड वोल्फ किशनर रिडक्शन। एंड व्हेन अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन इज सब्जेक्टेड फॉर दीज रिडक्शन देन प्रोडक्ट इज एल्केन। रिमेंबर, सो द क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन प्रोडक्ट इज एल्केन, मीन्स व्हेन अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स आर सब्जेक्टेड फॉर क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन। एक्चुअली इन क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन वी आर रिड्यूसिंग द अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ जिंक ऑब्लिक HCl, मीन्स जिंक HCl प्रेजेंस। विल टीच यू इन डिटेल क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन, दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन। नेक्स्ट वन इज वोल्फ किशनर रिडक्शन। इन वोल्फ किशनर रिडक्शन ऑल्सो द प्रोडक्ट इज एल्केन ओनली। सो जस्ट सी कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन प्रोडक्ट इज 1 degree 2 degree अल्कोहल, स्पेशल रिडक्शन प्रोडक्ट इज एल्केन। नाउ सम मोर डिटेल आइडिया इज गिवन रिगार्डिंग द कैटेलिटिक रिडक्शन, लाइक हाइड्रोजनेशन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ निकिल, पैलेडियम एंड प्लेटिनम। इफ अल्डिहाइड इज हाइड्रोजनेटेड प्रोडक्ट इज 1 degree अल्कोहल। नाउ दैट रिएक्शन आई हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड। टेक एनी जस्ट सी, सपोज दिस इज अल्डिहाइड CH3CH डबल बॉन्ड O, दिस इज काइंड ऑफ हाइड्रोजनेशन। सो जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, हियर टेक निकल PD आर PT। ओके, सो जस्ट सी शिफ्ट दिस बॉन्ड हियर, जस्ट एड 1H हियर एंड 1H हियर। सो जस्ट सी व्हाट इज दिस वन CH3C एंड हियर 1H, ऑलरेडी हियर H इज देयर एंड हियर OH। सो व्हाट इज दिस वन CH3CH2OH, व्हाट इज द प्रोडक्ट हियर 1 degree अल्कोहल। व्हाट इज दिस वन 1 degree अल्कोहल, दैट इज 1 degree अल्कोहल आर नॉट। ना इफ कीटोन इज हाइड्रोजनेटेड प्रोडक्ट इज 2 degree अल्कोहल। लेट अस टेक कीटोन CH3H2 सेम रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट, सो हियर व्हाट वुड बी देयर, दिस इज 2 degree अल्कोहल, दिस इज 2 degree आइसोप्रोपाइल अल्कोहल, 2 degree अल्कोहल। ओके, वन मोर थिंग इज देयर, इफ इन द चेन अलॉन्ग विद CHO एंड कीटोनिक ग्रुप C डबल बॉन्ड C इज देयर, मीन्स डबल बॉन्ड इज देयर, सो दीज हाइड्रोजनेटिंग एजेंट मीन्स निकिल, पैलेडियम एंड प्लेटिनम, दे विल हाइड्रोजनेट डबल बॉन्ड ऑल्सो। ओके, मीन्स टेक एनी पर्टिकुलर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज दिस इज देयर CH3CH डबल बॉन्ड CH CHO। ओके, एंड यू हैव टेकन दिस वन निकल PD एंड PT। ओके, सो इफ यू आर टेकिंग दिस वन हियर प्लस H2, नाउ रिक्वायर्ड नंबर ऑफ H2 यू कैन टेक, सो दिस ग्रुप विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू CH2OH प्राइमरी अल्कोहल, एंड नाउ हियर आल्सो हाइड्रोजनेशन वुड बी देयर, सो टोटल 2H2 इज रिक्वायर्ड। So here what would be the product? CH3, CH2, CH2, and here what is there? CH2OH. CHO can be written like that, C double bond O and 1 H. So when one hydrogen is here, one hydrogen with the oxygen. Okay, so just see, double bond is also hydrogenated. Okay, we are dealing in detail. Okay, so remember, nickel, palladium and platinum, they not only reduce CHO group, they hydrogenate the carbon-carbon double bond also if it is present. Okay, if it is present. But PCC, what about PCC? PCC does not affect the carbon-carbon double bond. It only reduces the CHO group or ketonic group, correct? Remember this one. So PCC is one type of selective reagent. Selective reagent, okay? Now, next one is reduction by sodium borohydride. Sodium, here same thing. Now, here I took this one, nickel palladium. Suppose, just I will rub this one and will write sodium borohydride. First take aldehyde, okay? Aldehyde, here. Here just take here sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride, NaBH4. So here what would be the product? CH3, here CH, and here OH, and here H. Okay, now this is reducing agent. What is their task? To furnish the nascent hydrogen. So if two nascent hydrogen is required to convert this aldehydes into 1 degree alcohol, so if means in presence of sodium borohydride, aldehyde is reduced to 1 degree alcohol, ketone is reduced to 2 degree alcohol. Okay, method is same only. Take ketone also. This is CH3. So here what would be there? Just see, CH3. This is 2 degree alcohol or not? Isopropyl alcohol, 2 degree alcohol. One more thing is there regarding sodium borohydride. Remember, sodium borohydride can only reduce the aldehydic and ketonic group. It does not reduce the carboxylic acid and their derivatives. So it will not reduce COOH group and acid derivatives like acid chlorides, acid anhydride, ester and acid amide. Remember, this is weak reducing agent. Okay. Moreover to this, it does not reduce carbon-carbon double bond if present in the chain. Means here, this reaction I wrote here, if you will take here sodium borohydride, sodium, let me write also, sodium borohydride, don't take nickel palladium. And this one, so just see, write down here sodium borohydride, sodium boro NaBH4. So here what would be there? Just see, CH3 CH double bond CH, and here what would be there? CH2 and OH. CH3 CH, see, double bond remains unchanged, double bond remains unchanged. Okay, now next one is reduction by lithium aluminium hydride. So lithium aluminium hydride also reduces aldehyde into 1 degree alcohol. Lithium aluminium hydride reduces ketone into 2 degree alcohol. But remember, it does not affect carbon-carbon double bond if present in the compound. So just see, now here take lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride. Again, it requires 2H. So here, what is the product? Just see. 1 degree alcohol. What is this one? This is aldehyde. This is 1 degree alcohol or not? Similarly, if you take ketone, so here what would be there? 2 degree alcohol. Okay? Similarly, suppose here lithium aluminium hydride you have taken. Lithium aluminium hydride. So it will not affect the carbon-carbon double bond. Product will be this one only. 2H is only required. Okay? So these are the things which are related with the these reducing agents. Sodium borohydride, lithium aluminium hydride and hydrogenating agent nickel, palladium and platinum. Okay? Now let us talk about the special reduction. Clemmensen reduction and Wolff-Kishner reduction. And here, unlike normal reducing agent product. Here you will have alkane rather than alcohol. Okay, that is the only purpose to teach this one. Normal reaction of aldehydes and ketone yields alcohol, but special reduction yields alkane. Okay, that is there. Just remember this one. Okay, so now see here, Clemmensen reduction, that is special reduction. So when aldehydes and ketone is reduced in presence of zinc amalgam / concentrate HCl, then C double bond O group is reduced to CHO2 group and product is alkane. So when aldehyde and ketone is reduced in presence of zinc amalgam / concentrate HCl, then C double bond O group is reduced to CH2 group and product is alkane. Just see here, CH3 C here H double bond O plus, what is there, take here 4H, and who will give this 4H? Zinc amalgam means Hg, and concentrate HCl. Okay, so just see, when zinc react with HCl, what is the product? ZnCl2 plus two nascent hydrogen. Okay, like that, correct or not? Now if you want more number of nascent hydrogen, then you have to increase the ratio of zinc and HCl. You will get the required number of nascent hydrogen here. Just see how the things are taking place. Just see, one of the product would be H2O. Okay, H2O means this O will go. Now this CO group will be converted into CH2 group. Already I wrote here. So CH3 is there. Now C is there, 1H is already there. Now put one more H and H here. So what is this one? This is CH3. What is this one? This is ethane. What is this one? Ethane. Correct or not? Now if you will take ketone, just see, CH3 double bond O plus, here what is there? 4H. Now here what is there? Zinc amalgam / HCl. So what is the product here? Just see, this C double bond O group again will be converted into CH2 group and plus the one molecules of water, H2O. Just see here, CH3 would be as such, here also C would be as such. Okay, then what is there? This is double bond is there. So now it will be removed, 1H here. Okay, so what is this one? This is CH3 CH2 CH3 CH2 CH3. What is this one? Propane. Okay, so now C double bond O group is reduced to CH2 group, that is why product is alkane. Not only this one, if you will take this one, what is this one? Acetophenone, C double bond O and CH3. So here also take 4H. Now in presence of zinc amalgam / HCl, so what is the product here? The product is this one, benzene. And here what would be there? Just see, this would be CH3 only, and here CH2 plus H2O. What is this one? Ethyl benzene. This is also hydrocarbon. Only the difference is they were the aliphatic hydrocarbon, this one and this one. This is aromatic hydrocarbon. Okay, this, just you see, this carbonyl carbon will receive 2 hydrogen and it will be converted into CH2, and remaining 2H they will form water molecules. Okay, that is there. So this is all about the Clemmensen reduction. And what is the function of zinc amalgam and HCl? This is the reaction is written here. Okay, now you will ask, what is the function of amalgam? Actually, when any alloy इन एनी अलॉय इफ एच जी इज प्रेजेंट सो दैट इज नोन एज अमलगम along with the name of other metal like sodium amalgam it means NaHg zinc amalgam means ZnHg correct and now what is the function of adding of this one actually the high reactivity of zinc can be controlled when it is alloyed with zinc that is why otherwise what would be there so many number of hydrogen will be evolved and you know hydrogen gas is highly inflammable so to control the reactivity of that particular metal You might have seen that amalgam is basically formed with the most reactive metal like sodium, potassium amalgam, sodium amalgam, zinc amalgam. Those metals which are reactive. So to control their reactivity, we are alloying with mercury. Okay. So this is all about the Clemmensen reduction. Now next one is Wolff-Kirchner reduction. In Wolff-Kirchner reduction, what we are doing? First aldehydes and ketone is treated with hydrazine. Then what will be formed? Acetaldehyde hydrazone and acetone hydrazone. And when this hydrazone is treated with strong base like KOH, potassium hydroxide at 453 Kelvin to 453 Kelvin to 473 Kelvin in ethylene glycol as a solvent, then it converted into alkane. It converted into alkane. Correct? Are you getting my point or not? So here two steps reaction is there. First one is the reaction of aldehydes and ketone with hydrazine. And whatever product form, that is hydrazone. Hydrazone should be treated with KOH at temperature 453 to 473 Kelvin temperature in presence of ethylene glycol as a solvent. Then alkane will be the product. So here also alkane will be the product. Okay, just we'll write the reaction also. Now just see here. This is the reaction of Wolff-Kirchner. Okay, just see here. This is aldehyde. First, what should be done? It should be treated with hydrazine. So this is H2O here. You know this reaction. Study only I have completed. Setting is required. So what is here? CH3CH double bond N NH2. And here what is there? CH3C here also CH3 double bond N. And here what is there? NH2. What is the name of this one? This is acetaldehyde hydrazone. What is this one? This is also acetone hydrazone. Okay. Now these two product must be treated with KOH at temperature 453 to 473 Kelvin. Here also KOH 453 Kelvin to 473 Kelvin temperature. Okay. So just see. Do one thing. This N2 should be removed from here. N2 nitrogen gas. Okay. And now this double bond automatically will be broken. This H2 will be associated with this carbon atom. Just see. This is CH3 is there. Here CH is already there. Now this H. Now here CH2. So this is CH3 now. Now same thing is here also. Just see. This is CH3. Here what would be there? C is there. Now this H2 and this CH3. Okay. Now this H2 only plus N2 gas. N2 gas. Here also N2 gas. Nitrogen gas. Now here ethylene glycol it is solvent. Ethylene glycol. No problem. Yes. So here in these two cases, Clemmensen and Wolff-Kirchner, the product is alkane. What is this one? This is ethane. What is this one? Ethane. What is this one? Propane. Yes, you have got the hydrocarbon. Okay, over. Now, oxidation reaction of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, now, difference between oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, so what are the difference between aldehydes and ketones? Just see. First, theoretical aspect must be studied thoroughly. Then only you can solve the remaining questions. And these are the very important points. So just see, what are the difference between oxidation of aldehydes and ketones? So just see, it oxidizes easily. Who? Aldehyde oxidizes easily due to presence of H atom with carbonyl carbon. In aldehyde, what is there? Just see, C double bond O group is there, here H is there. So due to presence of this H, oxidation is very easy. In case of ketone, what is there? This is carbonyl carbon. What is this one? Carbonyl carbon. And here H is not there. Now we'll tell you what is the importance of that H. Okay? Just see, when oxidizing agent furnishes one oxygen, already one O is here and H is here. Just it requires one oxygen to get converted into C double OH. The oxidation product of aldehydes and ketone is carboxylic acid only. So in aldehyde, one H is there, just it will receive one nascent oxygen and will be converted into C double OH group. Here what is there? Even if one more oxygen is available from the oxidizing agent, to get one hydrogen, it has to undergo cleavage of carbon-carbon bond. Okay? So that this is the only reason, that is why the oxidation of ketone is a difficult process. So first thing is, oxidation of aldehyde is easy due to the presence of hydrogen atom at carbonyl carbon. It oxidizes under drastic condition due to absence of H atom at carbonyl carbon. Okay? Next point is, oxidation product is single carboxylic acid. In case of aldehyde, what is there? The oxidation product is single carboxylic acid, which contains same number of carbon atom as has been contained by parent aldehyde or original aldehyde. Just see, RCCHO, okay, two carbon atom is there. Just see, this is the nascent oxygen which will come from oxidizing agent. Just add here one O, okay. Now RCOOH is ready. Okay, now here two carbon atom, one, two, here also two carbon atom. And moreover to this, you have got only single carboxylic acid product. Mixture you have not got. Here what is there? Oxidation product is mixture of carboxylic acid. And they contain less number of carbon atom than that of original ketones. Just see, this is acetone. This is containing three carbon atom, one nascent oxygen. It will come from the oxidizing agent. So now here you have got two carboxylic acid, acetic acid and formic acid, and they contains less number of carbon atom than that of this one. And just see here, rupturing of carbon carbon bond is also there, but here rupturing of carbon carbon bond is not there. Mixture of acid is formed due to rupturing of carbon carbon bond. Here single carboxylic acid product is formed due to no cleavage of carbon-carbon bond. So remember here, this is also difference. There is no rupturing of carbon-carbon. Rupturing means cleavage. And there is a rupturing of carbon-carbon bond. Here just see, oxidation in presence of common oxidizing agent. Okay? Means oxidation of aldehyde can be taken place in presence of common oxidizing agent. This is K2Cr2O7. And this is KMnO4, okay? This is HNO3. Remember, what about this one? Oxidation in presence of strong oxidizing agent. So just see, the difference between K2Cr2O7 is a common oxidizing agent if it is not present with concentrate H2SO4. Similarly, KMnO4 is a common oxidizing agent if it is not present with H2SO4. HNO3, normal HNO3 is a normal oxidizing agent, but concentrate HNO3 is a strong oxidizing agent. KMnO4 / concentrate H2SO4 or dilute H2SO4, not required concentrate, even dilute, if they are present with K2CR2O7 and KMnO4, so they become strong oxidizing agent. So सो द मीनिंग ऑफ स्ट्रांग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट विच फर्निसेस मोर नंबर ऑफ नेसेंट ऑक्सीजन ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन दैट इज वाई K2Cr2O एसिडिक K2Cr2O7 एंड एसिडिक आर एल्कलाइन K1O4 दे आर स्ट्रांग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट एज कम्पेयर टू नॉर्मल K2Cr2O7 K1O4 एंड HNO3 सिमिलरली कंसनट्रेट HNO3 ऑल्सो बिकम स्ट्रांग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट सो दीज आर द सम फोर कॉमन डिफरेंसेस टू मोर डिफरेंसेस आर देयर Actually, the oxidation of aldehydes takes place at room temperature only, normal temperature. But oxidation of ketone takes place at elevated temperature. Elevated temperature means at higher temperature. Okay, one thing. Second one thing, aldehyde can be reduced by normal reducing agent like Tollens reagent, Fehling solution. But it can't. It can't. Just see. We'll write those differences also. Okay. So two more differences are there. Oxidation of aldehyde takes place at normal temperature. Oxidation of ketones takes place at elevated temperature. That is the one difference. Next one difference it can be oxidized by mild oxidizing agent. Like Tollens reagent and Fehling solution. Tollens reagent is also known as silver mirror test. We'll tell you all these reagent reaction in detail with aldehydes and ketone. It cannot be oxidized by Tollens reagent and Fehling solution. So you should have idea about the Tollens reagent and Fehling solution. What are the Tollens reagent? What are the Fehling solutions? Okay, so now remaining reactions belongs to these two tests only. Before heading towards the oxidation by Tollens reagent and Fehling solution, there is one more rule that is known as Popoff's rule. Popoff's rule, okay. This rule governs the oxidation of unsymmetrical ketone. Because in ketone case, what is happening? Rupturing of carbon-carbon bond is taking place. So there is one rule which governs the rupturing of carbon-carbon bond in case of oxidation of unsymmetrical ketone. Unsymmetrical ketone means where R is not equal to R. Just see, in this case, one side this is the alkyl group, CH3, CH2, CH2. Another side CH3 group is there. Correct or not? See, now, same example I wrote this side also. Now just see, there are two cleavage sites. One cleavage is like that, means from here, cleavage may be taken place. So in this cleavage, C double bond O group, keto group stays with larger alkyl group. Another cleavage site is this one, like that. Okay. Now in this cleavage, CO group lies with smaller alkyl group. Correct or not? So Popoff's rule says that rupturing of carbon-carbon bond takes place in case of unsymmetrical ketone in such a way that keto group stays preferentially with smaller alkyl group. Means according to Popoff's rule, this is the correct way of cleavage. Now this is not a correct way of cleavage, because if carbon-carbon is ruptured from here, then keto group will be lies with the this group. Just see, what would be the product? Now oxidizing agent must be there, because when oxidizing agent is there, then only rupturing of carbon-carbon bond would be there. What would be the product? Product would be CH3, CH2, C double bond OH, means C double OH. Okay. Now in this case, what would be there? Another product would be CH3, CH2. Just a minute. Now one more CH2 group will come. Make this one CH2 and CH3. CH3, CH2, CH2, C double OH. Now another one would be, this is CH2O2, or this can be SC double OH. Correct or not? Because during the oxidation of ketone, mixture of carboxylic acid is formed. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, actually here product, let me check the number of carbon atom and example. इन एनसीईआरटी बुक. ओके, दिस इज करेक्ट एग्जांपल, नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. यस, सो मिक्सचर ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड इज ऑब्टेन्ड, कंसंट्रेट HNO3. हियर आल्सो व्हाट वुड बी देयर, कंसंट्रेट HNO3. ओके, सो हियर व्हाट इज द प्रोडक्ट, हियर CH3 CH2 ना COOH, एंड हियर प्लस व्हाट इज देयर CH3 COOH. सो दिस क्लीवेज इज अकॉर्डिंग टू पोपॉफ्स रूल, बिकॉज क्लीवेज इज टेकिंग इन ए सच वे दैट कीटोनिक ग्रुप प्रेफरेंशियली स्टेज विद स्मॉलर एल्काइल ग्रुप. नाउ हियर जस्ट सी, दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द रूल ऑफ ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ कीटोन ऑल्सो. हियर हाउ मेनी टोटल नंबर ऑफ कार्बोनेट, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 कार्बन एटम इज देयर. हियर व्हाट इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम, 3, एंड हियर 2. बट हियर व्हाट इज देयर, इफ यू गो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रूल, सो हियर व्हाट इज देयर, 4 कार्बन एटम. हियर व्हाट इज देयर, 1 कार्बन एटम. सो जस्ट सी, रूल सेज व्हेन ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ कीटोन इज टेकन प्लेस इन ए सच वे दैट द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड विच इज फॉर्म, विच मस्ट कंटेन्स लेसर नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम एज हैज़ बीन कंटेन्ड बाई द ओरिजिनल कीटोन. सो इन कीटोन हाउ मेनी कार्बन एटम, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ऑफकोर्स हियर 5 कार्बन एटम इज देयर, बट हियर 4 कार्बन एटम, हियर 1 कार्बन. दिस इज ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द रूल ओनली, बट दिस इज नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू पोपॉफ्स रूल, बिकॉज पोपॉफ्स रूल सेज दैट अनसिमेट्रिकल कीटोन ऑक्सीडेशन टेक्स प्लेस आर क्लीवेज ऑफ कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड टेक्स प्लेस इन ए सच ए वे दैट कीटो ग्रुप प्रेफरेंशियली स्टेज विद स्मॉलर एल्काइल ग्रुप. सो दिस इज नॉट ए करेक्ट क्लीवेज, दिस इज नॉट ए करेक्ट क्लीवेज अकॉर्डिंग टू पोपॉफ्स रूल. दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट ओनली, बट अकॉर्डिंग टू पोपॉफ्स रूल दिस इज नॉट ए करेक्ट क्लीवेज. सो वट इज द करेक्ट क्लीवेज, द करेक्ट क्लीवेज इज दिस वन अकॉर्डिंग टू पोपॉफ्स रूल. इफ नॉर्मल रपचरिंग इज देयर, सो यू विल हैव टू साइट, वन साइट अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वन, अनदर साइट दिस वन, एंड यू विल गेट 4 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड दैट हैज बीन गिवन इन द एनसीईआरटी बुक, इजंट इट. हियर इन एनसीईआरटी बुक दे हैव नॉट मेंशन एनीथिंग अबाउट द पोपॉफ्स रूल, डायरेक्टली दे क्लीव द कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड एंड फाउंड हियर 4 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, मिक्सचर ऑफ 4 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. ओके, सो हियर माय हेडिंग इज पोपॉफ्स रूल, दैट इज व्हाई दिस इज नॉट ए करेक्ट वर्जन, दिस इज ओनली करेक्ट वर्जन. ओके, सो पोपॉफ्स रूल, नाउ सो मेनी मीन्स वेन एवर ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ कीटोन इज देयर, यू शुड टेक केयर पोपॉफ्स रूल ऑल्सो. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट एंड फेलिंग सोल्यूशन एंड ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज. ओके, सो जस्ट सी, नाउ ऑक्सीडेशन बाय टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट. ओके, सो हियर व्हाट इज टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट, टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट इज माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. सो इट विल ऑक्सीडाइज द अल्डिहाइड, इट विल ऑक्सीडाइज द अल्डिहाइड एंड इन टर्न अल्डिहाइड विल रिड्यूस इट. जस्ट सी, इफ ऑक्सीडेशन एंड रिडक्शन रिएक्शन इज देयर, सो इफ वन इज ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, अदर मस्ट बी रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. ओके, सो टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट इज हियर माइल्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट एंड अल्डिहाइड इज रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. सो अल्डिहाइड विल रिड्यूस द टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट, वी कैन से, एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट विल ऑक्सीडाइज द अल्डिहाइड. बोथ आर करेक्ट ओनली. सो जस्ट सी, फर्स्ट लेट अस हैव आइडिया अबाउट व्हाट आर टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट. अमोनिकल सिल्वर नाइट्रेट सोल्यूशन, अमोनिकल सिल्वर नाइट्रेट सोल्यूशन इज टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट. ओके, दिस इज द सिंपल डेफिनेशन, बट जस्ट सी, इफ वी गो डीप इन टू दिस वन, देन वी हैव टू सी द मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ टॉलरेंस रिएजेंट. सो व्हेन सिल्वर नाइट्रेट इज ट्रीटेड विद एक्सेस ऑफ अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड टिल ग्रे प्रेसिपिटेट ऑफ HAG2O. व्हाट इज दिस वन, सिल्वर. See, silver has got 2 valencies. Here, what is the valency of silver? +1. Okay? So, silver first oxide. What is this one? Till the precipitate of silver first oxide, argentous oxide or silver first oxide PPT is formed. and gets dissolved. First, what should be there? Silver oxide PPT should be formed, and afterwards it should dissolve also. Till then you have to keep on adding the NH4OH. That is why NH4OH has been taken here excess. See how the reaction is taking place. You have to take silver nitrate, and here what is there? Ammonium hydroxide. So keep on adding this one to this solution, okay, drop by drop. Then you will get the gray PPT of this one, silver first oxide. Ammonium nitrate and H2O will form. So this is the first step till the gray PPT is formed. And afterwards what is written? And gets dissolved. So just see, this is silver oxide, silver first oxide. This is silver first oxide. It should be treated with ammonium hydroxide. It should be treated with ammonium hydroxide, because in the first step it will not be consumed. Now this PPT which is formed in the step number first, that should be dissolved. Now keep on adding the silver ammonium hydroxide, then you will get the one coordination compound. What is this one? AgNH3 whole twice, positive sign, OH negative. This is only tollens reagent. So tollens reagent in IUPAC system, what would be the name of this one? Diamine silver first hydroxide. What is this one? What is tollens reagent? Diamine silver first hydroxide. What is the oxidation state of silver here? Plus one. So this is the methods of preparation of tollens reagent. Okay, no problem at all. You can balance the reaction also. Now try to understand. This is not our purpose. Our purpose is how tollens reagent oxidize aldehyde. That is our purpose. So try to understand. Here we have got that tollens reagent is this one. In this way only you should write. So when aldehyde is treated with tollens reagent, then it reduces Ag positive. This Ag positive present in tollens reagent into metallic silver. Metallic silver, which forms bright layer of silver on inner surface of test tube, and in turn aldehyde RCHO oxidizes into R. This is carboxylate ion. RC double bond O, O single negative sign, carboxylate ion. So just see here reaction I wrote. This is aldehyde. This is now reducing agent. So it will reduce the tollens reagent silver first ion, silver single positive ion, into silver metallic silver. These metallic silver inside the test tube, they will be present. They will form the bright layer of metallic silver. That is why this test is known as silver mirror. You know that silver is a very shiny metal, isn't it? We can see our face. So inner surface of test tube will be covered with the bright layer of silver. So this is silver mirror. What is this one? Silver mirror. And now this is reducing agent here. So this will be reduced into carboxylate ion. This is carboxylate ion. Okay. Now tollens reagent is this one. Okay. And this will be this only reducing this one into silver. And we can say this tollens reagent is oxidizing this one aldehyde into carboxylate ion. Okay, so both are correct thing only. Aldehyde is here reducing agent, tollens reagent is here oxidizing agent. So most important thing is this one, precipitate of silver, which is forming inside the or inner surface of the test tube. Okay, this is only silver mirror test. The most important thing is, just see, this test will be given by both aliphatic and aromatic aldehyde, but ketone will not give this test. So we can use this test to distinguish between aliphatic ketone and aliphatic aldehyde. Similarly, we can use this reaction to distinguish between aromatic aldehyde and ketones, but this test will not be used to distinguish between aliphatic aldehyde and aromatic aldehyde, like benzaldehyde and acetaldehyde. They can't be distinguished because both are giving this test. But acetone and benzaldehyde can be distinguished. Acetone and benzaldehyde can be distinguished. Acetaldehyde and acetone can also be distinguished. because aldehyde will give this test, ketone will not give. Okay, so remember this one, this test has been given by both aliphatic and aromatic aldehyde, but has not been given by the ketones. This is all about the tolerance region. Now next one is aldehyde can reduce the failing solution, or you can say failing solution can oxidize the aldehyde. Remember these two things. Aldehyde is reducing tolerance reagent and failing solution, and in turn getting oxidized by tolerance reagent and failing solution. Okay, just see here, failing solution. So what is failing solution? Failing solution is mixture of two solution, failing solution A and failing solution B. Failing solution first, that is the aqueous solution of copper sulfate. Failing solution B is alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate, Rochelle salt. Okay, means alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate, that is also known as Rochelle salt. This aqueous solution of copper sulfate, this is known as Cu2 positive, means this will furnish Cu2 positive ion, and alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate, that will furnish 5OH negative ion. Okay, because this is having sodium potassium tartrate hydroxide ion. Okay, and now the mixture of Cu2 positive ion and 5OH negative, that is known as failing solution. Means failing solution can be represented by this one, Cu2 positive and 5OH negative. So it is understood that Cu2 positive will come from failing solution A and this will come from failing solution B. Okay, I'm now just see. Before the test, both solution, means failing solution A and B, should be mixed in equal quantity. Before they are being treated with the aldehydes. Okay, remember this one. I'm now just see what would be there. When aldehyde is heated with failing solution A and B, reddish brown ppt of cuprous oxide, in that case silver, metallic silver was formed. Here what is formed? Cuprous oxide ppt is formed, reddish brown ppt. See how the reaction is taking place. RCHO, this is in place of R, you can write CH3. Okay, Cu2 positive plus 5OH, this is only failing solution. This is failing solution. Now what is this one? This is carboxylate ion. Now plus Cu2O and 3H2O, this is reddish brown PPT. What is this one? Reddish brown PPT. Means RCHO aldehyde will reduce this one Cu2 positive ion into Cu2O, reduced. Just see here, this is 2 positive, here in copper is single one. So what is there? Undergoing reduction, and it means it is oxidizing agent, and now this is reducing agent. What is this one? Reducing agent. Okay, so just see, this one is reducing this one into this one, and in turn getting oxidized into this one, carboxylate ion. Just that much only you should write. Now what other important thing is failing solution test is given by aliphatic aldehyde only. Aromatic aldehyde will not give. Similarly, ketone will also not give this test. Ketone, neither aliphatic nor aromatic ketone will give this test. So we can use this test to distinguish between aldehydes and ketone, especially aromatic aldehyde and aromatic ketone, and aliphatic aldehyde and aliphatic ketones, aliphatic aldehyde and aromatic ketones also. Okay, because this test has not been given by aliphatic and aromatic ketones. Understood or not? This test is given by the aliphatic aldehydes only. Now neither ketones nor aromatic aldehyde will give this test. It means this test can be used to distinguish between aliphatic aldehydes and aromatic aldehydes, Similarly, this test can be used to distinguish between aliphatic aldehydes with aliphatic ketone and aliphatic aldehydes with aromatic ketones also. Here I wrote question, how will you distinguish between CH3CHO and C6H5CHO? Just see, this is aliphatic, this is aromatic, Fehling solution can be used. Now this will, CH3CHO will give this test and C6H5CHO, benzaldehyde, will not give this test. So now here just you put CH3, so here also you will get CH3, rest every test is okay, every reaction is okay. And in second step just write C6H5 plus Fehling solution, no reaction, distinction is over. Next one is CH3CHO and CH3COCH3. Now just see, this is aliphatic aldehyde, this is aliphatic ketone. Tollens, with the help of Tollens reagent also it can be distinguished, because ketones are not responding to Tollens reagent, and similarly they are not responding to the Fehling solution. So either one can be utilized. Now you can write the reaction, okay, where RCHO you have written, write CH3CHO. And now Ag NH3 whole twice, single positive, OH negative, and CH3C double O negative, then Ag positive, now NH3 plus H2O, that reaction you should write. Next one is C6H5CHO and CH3CO. So this is, just see, this is aromatic aldehyde, and what about this one? This is aliphatic ketone. Now just see, C6H5 can give the Tollens reagent test, but it will not give the Fehling solution. So which test we can utilize here? We can utilize here Tollens reagent test. Ketone will not give, benzaldehyde will give. Aromatic aldehydes are not giving the Fehling test, but they are giving the Tollens reagent test. Okay? So in this way, such kind of question you are going to have. Okay? So please just take care. This is all about the Fehling solution. There is one more oxidation reaction, that is haloform reaction or iodoform reaction. Now in case of alcohol, already I taught that reaction. Okay? Now in just one step will be less, rest everything will be same. Now already time is over, so will not teach, will teach you next video, that one. And now your pre-board is coming fastly, so please prepare. Now very soon I am going to give you the blueprint also, questions blueprint. Okay, so just see, probably tomorrow is a Sunday, I make one video where I will solve some difficult questions, and along with the NCRT exercise of alcohol chapter. So tomorrow you may get the unofficial video, and there only blueprint also I will tell you. Okay, so hopefully you will watch that one, because that is unofficial video and you are not watching the official video, so how can I expect that you will watch the unofficial video? Nevertheless, I will try from my side. Thank you.